Do-it-yourself wedding projects have become increasingly popular. This is a great way to both stay on your wedding budget and also add a personal touch to your special day. Joining us is lifestyle expert and event producer Ken Macaron to show us how. Good morning, Ken.
Good morning, Megan. How are you doing today?
Good, good. And you've got some goodies here.
I do. I mean, there's a lot more to the do-it-yourself bride. You know, Pinterest has really become a really good asset for people to use. You can go there, you can see what you're going to need, and then you can really tailor it to make it a personal touch. That's the thing. You have to remember your wedding has to be personal. There has to be those personal touches there because it's your wedding. It's your wedding day. So there's different things that you can do to really tie it together.
And it doesn't have to be expensive.
No, that's the thing. Is everything, these weddings are going to have to be over the top expensive. You know what? Put your money where you really want to put your money. And then with your decorations, that's where you're going to give your personal touches.
Okay. And are we reusing some stuff too? Let's start over here.
Yeah. What's great about this is that old books, you can take old books from your house, whether they're childhood books or whether they're books from college. Maybe you met your college sweetheart. It's a great thing to do on your tables is to have the books stacked. And then with a mason jar, you can just easily do different levels, which will always give you interest to the table. Add some flowers in there, and you have a beautiful centerpiece with flowers, books, and a mason jar. How expensive is that?
Exactly, and it takes up a lot of good room, too.
Exactly. It takes up a lot of space on your table, and with all the different levels, it's really important that you have those levels because that's what's going to create interest, and it's going to draw us a little bit more of a dramatic touch to your table.
That's true. I never thought that that's what it does. And what about this globe that we have?
I know. You're thinking, well, what's going on with this globe, you know, for a wedding? But what I really like to do is something for your guest book that isn't going to get folded up, put away, and never seen again. So the great thing is here is that this is a globe. So say you're a big traveler. This is a great idea, and you always want to use a Sharpie marker that is going to be, you know, smudge-free. And you have to remember, make sure it's smudge-free because everybody's going to be writing over it, and you don't want your fist to smudge. So something like this for maybe the world's travelers, or maybe something like a guitar for the musicians, or an oar for those people that like to do those wilderness.
So people are signing like, hey, good luck, and happy to be here, all of your guests. That's a wonderful idea.
Yeah, because then you can display it.
And lastly, I'm seeing that there's a vintage photograph in here.
Yes, that's the great thing is that you want to make sure that your whole family's involved in your wedding day because how did you get there? It wouldn't be without them unless you got there. So let's pay a little bit of homage to them. And a great thing to do is for those that have passed or those that are coming back is to have old photos. Now, these are great to do. They're wedding photos, family photos, grandparents, aunts, uncles. That's what you want to do. You want to show them your marriage was so successful. We're looking forward to having just as successful of a marriage as you. There's something great for your card table, for your gift table, or maybe for your cake table.
So display not just one. You can have like a couple of them all together?
Yeah, I think it would be great to have all of the families together. You know, you have your grandparents from each side of the family, maybe your groom, so maybe four pictures. I think it's great to show where you were and where you're going.
And maybe even use some books or something to elevate it.
Exactly.
And have that, draw that interest. Ken, thanks so much for joining
us
today.
Thank you, Megan.
And if you stick around too, Ken's going to be coming up later on the show, and he's going to show us some beautiful bridal looks for the season and some more DIY wedding tips. You can head to our website, WPRI.com/theroadshow.